young pair of newlyweds who lived in this nice little modern house. Wait till you see how they furnished it. They've got simply everything. Well, perhaps not quite everything. You know how it is. You expect certain wedding presents and you don't get them.
Must get that alarm clock mended, Henry. That's the second kind of sleep you've ever kept.
Oh, what's the matter, dear? What's he doing under the bed?
Look at my hair this morning.
I dropped my toilet stud.
I'll never use that shampoo again.
I've lost my toilet stud. And if I don't find it, I'll miss the train. And if I miss the train, I should be late for the office. And if I'm late for the office, old Parkinson will send for me. And if...
Is that it?
Is what was?
Your son.
Fred. Oh! Went right into my foot.
The fuss we make about a little pain.
A little pain? You tried stepping on your collar stud. No, 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 no. Well, you tried stepping on your suspender. There are no clean socks. Oh, well, they weren't there just now. Things just appear by magic for you. Do you call this collar iron?
What did you say? You have to wear this one?
Well, I'd just try and go to the office without a collar, wouldn't I?
You know, you've only got one collar.
You'd be quite right, wouldn't it?
This is one by lining again.
Don't bother, it's not even washed properly. I'll find the one I wore yesterday. If that's your little game, you can get on with it.
First time I've ever been asked without kissing her goodbye.
Well, it's always got to be a first time for everything.
there are other bottles, Mother Eve.
I see.
And you have to fill it with hot water.
Oh, no, you don't have to. The water now that heats the water, it turns it back.
If the water in the tap isn't very hot.
But naturally, you have hot water in your tap, you use it.
Where's the, agitator?
Agitator?
Yes, to push the clothes on.
Oh, with a Hoover, you don't push the clothes about. You see that?
Uh-huh.
It's called a pulsator.
And Mrs. James explained how the pulsator works. Not churning the clothes, but swirling the water through the clothes, thoroughly washing even the most delicate fabric, and what a really large tub it has, so that it could take quite a large family wash. Having shown Mabel the water line, Mrs. James then pointed out that only a Hoover washing machine has a pulsator set in the side of the tub, which is the real secret of perfect washing. When you've filled it with water up to the mark, you take out the hose and switch on the timer. Look how the water starts swirling round. Now you put in the washing powder, and the water will go on whirling round until you have a perfect lather for washing. Now you switch it off and put in the clothes. You see, exclaimed Mrs. James, you put the clothes in down the side like this, so that you don't get pockets of air forming. You can put in 6 pounds of clothes at a time. It holds a lot, said Mabel. Yes, said Mrs. James. Well, I reckon that's 6 pounds, and enough for this batch. Now I set the dial for 4 minutes. That means that the clothes will be washed for 4 minutes, and then the machine will switch itself off. I put the lid on in case there should be a splash or two, not that there's much. And that's all you do, so far as the washing is concerned. Soap powder, warm water, and 4 minutes. At the end of 4 minutes, the machine switched itself off. There it is, said Mrs. James, all beautifully washed, and now it's ready to be dried in this thin dryer. No dragging it out to the garden, and no hanging it in the kitchen. No wringer, asked Mabel. No wringer, said Mrs. James. We just pack it all in, don't arrange it carefully. It spins round, and the water is extracted. How can it really get rid of the water, asked Mabel. Watch, said Mrs. James. The first water that comes out is the soapy lather. We don't want to waste it, so we return it to the tub. Just look at the water that's removed when the clothes spin round. And while the clothes are spinning the first water out, we put the second batch of clothes into the tub, ready to be washed. Oh, said Mabel, you can actually have one lot of clothes washing while another's being dried. That's right, said Mrs. James. Now, these clothes are not yet rinsed, so we pour clean water into the dryer through this hose. The other hose goes into the sink. The water that comes out now will be the first rinse, and we don't want that to go back into the tub. Look, here it comes. By the way, I can't show you the spin dryer we've been running, because it won't work unless the lid's on. That's a patent Hoover safety device. The moment you lift the lid, the spin dryer quickly stops. Now you pour in water for the second rinse, said Mrs. James, and not only will your clothes now be clean, but every particle of soap will be extracted from them. This time, as you'll see, the water that's returned from the hose to the sink will be perfectly clean. And now see for yourself what the clothes are like. They're really amazingly dry, really ready to iron. Well, that's the first step. By the way, you realize that the whole job of washing and spin drying takes only 8 minutes. 4 minutes for washing and 4 minutes for drying. Now the second batch should be washed, so we just take it out and transfer it to the dryer. Now while that one is drying, we just turn this switch which pumps the water out of the tub. This Hoover-matic is fully automatic, you see. Now, here's the water from the tub and from the dryer going down the sink, and we've now finished with the soapy lather. And by the time the tub's emptied, we shall have rinsed these clothes twice, and they too are ready for ironing.
Hmm, dryer for ironing. All the right things are, and the heavier ones are ready for the line.
Well, I must have been feeling when I was.
And don't forget that this time you washed it with one hand. didn't you use your Hoover too much?
My Hoover?
I had a Hoover.
I'll get mine and do your cleaning for you.
Oh, thank you very much, Mrs. Bedford.
It isn't the same, but I can't think how you manage without a Hoover.
Oh, I use dustpan, brush and dustpan.
Good. Let me do your cooking and coffee while I'm here.
Would you?
Polished yet. You see, you've only been brushing the polish evenly over the surface of the liner. polished liner drying all over the halls. For really delicate finishes, tabletops, for instance, there are lamb's wool pads. Also, it can be easily turned into a scrubber by the addition of two scrubbing brushes.
Well, it's much better to go down on your hands and knees. Look at the polish it is. Well, I have to go now. I'll leave you the polish on. Come back to you tomorrow. Oh, how nice of you. But you are so nice. Take care of you. Goodbye. And thank you very much.
Thank you.
something for you.
Oh, it must have your hand, too.
And what a naughty girl you are, dear. Go to Hartford, and the doctor says you should rest in the rest.
Oh, Henry, what a lovely man. Wonderful of you.
Wonderful. You're the wonderful one, darling. You do the washing, the ironing, the polishing, the cleaning, and all with one hand.
Henry, it wasn't really as difficult as you think.
Huh?
You see, it's only because of the Hoover products from our neighbors that I was able to do anything at all.
The Hoover products?
Yes. My neighbor works them so easy. And I really enjoyed using them. They do a wonderful job. And the time they pay. You know, I really think we all should.
Just a moment, darling. Something I want to tell you. I've decided that this is a doctor new way of life. Hoover for happier homes. I think we ought to go shopping.
Can we afford to have all those things?
We can't afford not to have all those things. Well, maybe half purchase, maybe one at a time, but we're going on to the Hoover dealer tomorrow.
Oh, darling.
What's that?
The bell. Oh, it came off.
It's pretty tight on again, isn't it?
Henry. You know, one of these Hoover washing machines spin dries the clothes as well. I must get a bath for a lovely towel. Using in this film were the Hoovermatic washing machine, the Hoover cleaner, the Hoover polisher and scrubber, the Hoover steam or dry iron. Why don't you go to your Hoover dealer today and, like Henry and Mabel, see about making your home a happier home with Hoover help? After all, you don't need to strain your wrist to do it.